Hi, I'm Shawna Coronado, and I am standing in front of a 500-gallon rain exchange system from Aquascape. It is so cool. It's something the everyday person can do. Collect rainwater off your roof, put it into the rain cistern collection system, and then reuse it whenever you want it. I can water my gardens, the vegetable garden. It's amazing. I'm very curious about how big companies use water conservation-wise in a creative way. I recently got back from Ireland. It was amazing. I got to meet the managing director of Glenisk, and he gave me a tour of the reed systems and the reed beds behind his factory. And here's the thing, they take all the stuff that comes out of the factory, they put it in the ponds. The ponds and the reeds reprocess it and make it fresh water again. It is wonderful. All big companies should be doing this. Come on, you gotta go take a look with me.
This would be covered over with the reeds as well there.
Oh, so this entire,
as you see it, is a pond.
And it's filled with reeds, which then filter chemicals that make the water fresh again.
Correct.
Yes. So cool. That is amazing.
And this is the new technology. This technology was introduced to Ireland 100 years ago by the British Army to handle their sewage water coming from their garrisons, from their barracks.
Understood. And look at it, you can hear all the wildlife.
You hear the birds.
Now, there has to be a lot of wildlife that hides in here. Do you know what different species we...
You'd have ducks and you'd have waterfowl, which are water hens, as they're known locally. They're a small little blackbird that mimic the actions of a duck, but are not a duck. But after that, yeah, you've got all sorts of insect activity in there.
Which attracts then the next level of
birds,
predator.
Yeah. The wastewater comes in and it's pretty, pretty dismally grey, shall we say.
Where does the wastewater come from?
The washings of our plant, the rainwater, the yard water, which in itself will be dirty as well.
Understood.
And everything basically. All the water that enters our areas comes down here. And it goes through a natural process of the nutrients are taken out of the water, and ultimately it gets to a standard that's acceptable, a non-polluting standard. So,
but it goes through this process to get to that standard.
Correct.
And so it's a grey water processing system.
Or cleansing system.
Cleansing system.
Yeah. And that cake, crust,
yes.
The reeds, it gives the reeds something from which to establish themselves on.
Okay.
And so they spread because the reeds need something solid matter underneath them.
Oh.
And so the reeds will turn that for all intents and purposes. They'll eat that up, the reeds, the crust.
And it turns into a soil of sorts then?
It's been used, yeah.
Fertilizer.
It's a fixing matter, shall we say. But I mean, they do their job. What's this kid?
What?
I heard about the rain. Yeah, but
kind wind. Kind wind? Yes. Oh, kind wind.
What's kind wind?
No wind.
There's no wind.
The wind turbine is
so turning. You're concerned about the wind turbine.
Yeah. She's wondering why it's not turning.
It's not turning because it's not a windy day.
Yeah.
That doesn't happen very often.
No, not very often.
Do you have lots of wind here?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, shortly he'll turn.
How amazing was that? Ah, a tour of the reed beds in Ireland. Beautiful. And to think that this big company is doing something that's so inspirational and good for the environment, that's what we should all be doing. I want you to make a difference for the environment too. Whether you're a homeowner doing something simple like collecting rainwater, or you're a big corporation that's processing things chemical-free, it's the way to go. So come on, make a difference today. You can do it.